I've just seen on Facebook that one of my family friends is selling Ozempic. Now, she's not a doctor, she's not a nurse, she's not a pharmacist. So why is she doing this? It turns out there's now an Ozempic underground, a black market for the skinny jab. And the reason why all centers around this graph. Ozempic causes your weight to drop off your bones, but how? And I want to know, is there any side effects? And what happens when you stop? In this video, I'm going to be exploring all of those questions. We're going to get to the bottom of the Ozempic underground, and we're going to work out why there's so much hype around this drug. So I'm Jack, I'm a doctor in the UK, and it's probably time for me to get up, isn't it?
Life expectancy decreases as the amount of overweight increases.
The popular type 2 diabetes drug Ozempic has been flying off the shelves.
To understand how Ozempic makes your weight fall off, we need to go back and understand how this all started. It was approved in 2017 as a management for type 2 diabetes to help control their blood sugar. Your blood sugar is regulated by multiple mechanisms, but the one we're going to cover here is insulin. When your blood sugar rises following a meal, you need a way to bring it back down. The way to do that is by shifting that sugar from your blood into your cells. The key that opens the doors to your cells is insulin. In diabetes, this mechanism is impaired. So in type 1 diabetes, you no longer produce insulin. So basically, you've got no keys to those cells. And in type 2 diabetes, on the other hand, you still produce insulin, but the sensitivity of the cells to the insulin is reduced. So basically, the key stops working as well as it used to. The risk with type 2 diabetes is that all this excess sugar that isn't being shifted into your cells then damages your blood vessels, your kidneys, your eyes, and much, much more. In type 2 diabetes, we have various drugs to try and increase the sensitivity of the muscles to insulin. But there's also one key solution that they need: weight loss. When scientists were working out how appetite works, they came across this hormone, GLP-1. It slows the movement of food through your gut, making you feel fuller, quicker. And it also alters the signaling between your brain and your gut to make you feel less hungry. There's a big problem with GLP-1 though. It's broken down really, really quickly. But in 2017, scientists found a way to stop it being broken down as quickly. And the result was a drug called semaglutide. But that's a mouthful. So what did they call it? People that started to use it noticed something huge. Their weight started doing this. It wasn't just them that noticed it, everybody else started to notice it too. In 2021, Ozempic was approved for chronic weight management by the FDA in America. That's when it took the step from type 2 diabetes drug to weight management drug. You won't believe what happened next. Everybody started talking about Ozempic. Look at how massive this rise in interest was, both on TikTok videos, on Google searches. There was so much interest. The rise in interest caused a massive rise in people wanting these drugs. Why? Because obesity is a huge problem. And while the classic answer of eat less, move more is a message that we need to share, it oversimplifies obesity. It is a complex metabolic disease with poorly functioning pathways that regulate both body weight and body fat. Ozempic provides a solution that many people have been looking for, but it's far from a miracle drug. The benefits have been oversold while the risks haven't been talked about enough. Alongside their fat loss, people started to notice that they were losing muscle as well. While people were happy with their bodily aesthetics, their face started to change as well, being termed Ozempic face. When the people increase the dose too quickly, they lose the fat cells on their face as well as their waist. While the impacts on appetite may be seen as positive, people also started to notice the negative side of that too, developing nausea and vomiting from Ozempic. Some patients even developed pancreatitis and alopecia. So these are the documented side effects that I've been talking about, but there are many, many more out there. Because this drug is only licensed in the UK for patients with a BMI of over 35, and in some exceptions, in BMIs of over 30. Why? partly because we don't know how it impacts people with a BMI lower than that, because it wasn't tested on them. But now, with this trend of people wanting to use Ozempic for weight loss, just for their summer holidays when they want to lose a tiny bit of body fat, they're not obese, so we don't know how it impacts them. Ozempic is a life-changing drug for those who need it. Those with a BMI of over 35, or for management of type 2 diabetes, it could add years to their life. But for all of those people who are looking to use it to lose a tiny bit of weight, there are a lot of risks with that, and we don't actually understand how this drug fully impacts you. Just to add to this, I want to know what happens when you stop it. We've seen that the weight loss impacts of Ozempic are undeniable, but you can only take it for a maximum of 2 years. So what happens when you stop? Does that weight do this or this? In the Step 1 trial, they took 1,961 adults with obesity and treated them with semaglutide, Ozempic, 2.4 milligrams once a week, or a placebo for 68 weeks. That's the graph we've been seeing throughout this video. On average, they lost 17.3% of their body weight. When they stopped it, the line did this. In the year following the stoppage, they regained about 2/3 of the lost weight. They went from 17.3% loss to 5.6% in that year. And their improvements in blood pressure and blood sugar also tended to revert towards the baseline levels after they stopped it. There's a bigger problem now. Bigger than the side effects, bigger than the weight gain, a problem that's now causing arrests and hospitalizing people. What happens when you have a surge in demand with not enough supply? People realize that there's a lot of money to be made, and where there's money, there's an illegal market. Here's a real Ozempic pen, and here's a fake one that the German authorities found. The so-called skinny jab is now being sold through Facebook, Etsy, and Instagram. We have non-regulated drugs being sold by people with no qualifications, and as you can imagine, that's causing massive problems. The medicine regulators in the UK, the MHRA, published a warning on these fake Ozempic devices. They said that the contents may not match the ingredients on the label. But it gets worse because it's the result of that that we are seeing in hospital. So people have come in to the hospital with hypoglycemic shock and even gone into comas because of these drugs. One of those mismatches of ingredients could be swapping the semaglutide for insulin, which is potentially life-threatening depending on the dose. For those selling Ozempic illegally, please stop. You're putting everyone at risk. And for those considering Ozempic, please visit your doctor and discuss it. It's a very big decision and it should not be taken lightly. Thanks very much for watching. I make videos to try and help you understand your health and to build healthy habits based on that understanding. Subscribe if you like the idea of that, and watch this video to see how steroids could break your heart.